Hey, what's up, guys? Mikey here. For some reason, I have this sudden urge to eat this entire bowl of strawberry jello. It's like there's this tiny microscopic bug that's controlling my mind, making me want to do it. But I set the bowl down, so I think I fought off that urge. I don't know why, but I couldn't control myself.
Well, we're 6 episodes in, and we only know 6 of the 7 main characters. We still have yet to meet the final main character, but that is about to change. Plankton is the episode where SpongeBob meets Mr. Krabs' archenemy, Plankton, and Plankton tries to control SpongeBob's mind to steal the Krabby Patty secret formula. It's also the first episode with the character's name and an exclamation point. Nickelodeon really knows how to make an episode title seem exciting. Like jellyfishing, this episode aired on July 31st, 1999. This episode introduces the 7th main character, Sheldon Plankton, who is also the main antagonist of the series.
Wait, all 7 main characters are introduced after the first 7 episodes? It's all starting to come together.
His main goal in life is to steal the Krabby Patty secret formula and put Mr. Krabs and the Krusty Krab out of business. This is a recurring theme in the series, so it's important that this episode introduces our main antagonist well. This episode also introduces the Chum Bucket, Plankton's home and the least popular fast food restaurant in Bikini Bottom, and Karen, Plankton's computer wife. These characters and this location don't appear as much as Mr. Krabs and the Krusty Krab, but they are still integral parts of the series. Karen also isn't a main character in the series, but like Larry the Lobster, she is one of the most notable recurring characters to me. She doesn't get as much screen time in the earlier episodes, but she appears much more often in the modern seasons and even has character development. She has a mobile form, which doesn't appear until the SpongeBob SquarePants movie. But I'm getting way off topic again, so let's watch this episode and see how well Plankton is introduced. So the episode starts up.
Sorry to interrupt, but we haven't seen the Krusty Krab for the last 5 episodes in a row, so I really need to see it again.
And we see the Krusty Krab for the first time since Help Wanted.
Oh, thank God.
SpongeBob is doing his usual antics slash unique twist on making Krabby Patties, and Squidward is yelling at SpongeBob to get the Krabby Patty ready. This time, SpongeBob pulls the ingredients in his pores and shakes himself up and pulls the finished Krabby Patty out from under Squidward's nose. Before Squidward can take it, the Krabby Patty starts moving around the kitchen on its own. SpongeBob calls Mr. Krabs thinking the Krabby Patty's haunted, but Mr. Krabs says that it's not a ghost and that it's Plankton, who reveals his intention to discover the Krabby Patty formula and run Mr. Krabs out of business. Then he says his most iconic line.
I went to college!
So did I!
Mr. Krabs launches Plankton back to the Chum Bucket after foiling his plans again. Mr. Krabs then explains to SpongeBob how he and Plankton are enemies and has been trying to steal the secret formula for years. Later that night, after the Krusty Krab closes, SpongeBob leaves and starts to walk home, and he hears a voice and walks towards it until he accidentally steps on Plankton. SpongeBob and Plankton officially meet for the first time, and Plankton tries to convince SpongeBob they are friends, but SpongeBob doesn't think so since they barely know each other. Plankton gives SpongeBob a golden spatula saying it's a gift from a friend, and says that tomorrow is his birthday, and that he wants SpongeBob to give him a present, which is of course, a Krabby Patty. And then SpongeBob realizes Plankton's intentions, and then leaves Plankton saying that he would never give him a Krabby Patty even if they are friends, but Plankton thinks otherwise. Later that night, when SpongeBob goes to bed, we see flowers on his mattress.
Ever seen that?
Plankton's hiding under one of those flowers.
That's probably why.
He enters SpongeBob's head through one of his pores and finds SpongeBob's brain. After briefly chasing SpongeBob's brain and calling it a swine, he tapes it down and takes out his mind control device. He connects it to SpongeBob's brain and now he has control of him. He controls SpongeBob to his will, and after he leaves his house, he realizes something is wrong with him and calls Squidward for help. SpongeBob breaks the wall of Squidward's bedroom, walks through, and breaks the wall on the opposite side, with Squidward screaming at him the whole time.
Why is his bedroom on the first floor, though?
SpongeBob starts talking in Plankton's voice, insulting Squidward, and at this point, SpongeBob looks inside his head and sees Plankton controlling his brain. Plankton continues controlling SpongeBob, eventually walking him through the Krusty Krab with a Krabby Patty in his hands. He takes him to the Chum Bucket, Plankton's restaurant that doesn't have customers.
It's late at night, so it's probably closed, too.
Plankton takes SpongeBob to his lab and laboratory. While SpongeBob tries to resist, it's no use. Plankton shows off his analyzer and how it tells the ingredients of whatever is put into it, and demonstrates by putting in seaweed, and Karen, his computer wife, states the ingredients. Plankton starts to force SpongeBob to drop it in, and right before, he asks for any last words. SpongeBob lets out a heartfelt speech on how he failed to save the formula, leading him into stating what is put on a Krabby Patty, revealing the formula anyway.
Or does he?
Plankton gets excited and jumps out of SpongeBob's head, but he falls in the analyzer and ends up stuck inside Karen. SpongeBob leaves with the Krabby Patty, with Plankton screaming at SpongeBob, demanding him to bring it back, and the episode ends. So that was Plankton, and I have to say, the episode is really good. Plankton is a great character and works really well as the main antagonist of the series. His character is shown off perfectly, a diabolical villain with a weakness slash soft spot that can sometimes get the best of him. Karen is portrayed as just part of Plankton's analyzer, and her name isn't said in the episode, just the end credits. Since the focus is on Plankton, the Chum Bucket isn't shown off too much, but the main characteristic of it is shown off well, Plankton's home slash lair and the least popular restaurant in Bikini Bottom. It's still iconic and will get a lot more focus later. Well, now all seven of the main characters are introduced in the series, and they are a very dynamic bunch, and all their antics in the future are going to be memorable at the very least. Now back to the episode itself. Of course, it's a great episode, although there are a couple things I have to say. Why is Squidward's bedroom on the first floor? Even if this is the first time Squidward's bedroom is shown, it still doesn't make sense in a logical manner, but neither do a lot of the things in this show, so whatever. If the Krusty Krab is closed, where does the fresh Krabby Patty come from? Of course, since Plankton was controlling SpongeBob, he probably forced SpongeBob to make it. And now, the big point. At the end, does SpongeBob truly reveal the secret formula? I'd say no. Sure, he does say the veggies and cheese that are on it, but any hamburger slash cheeseburger from any restaurant looks like that and has those same veggies and cheese. Since Plankton continues to find the formula in future episodes, it's obvious he's trying to learn the ingredients that makes the meat of the Krabby Patty. Literally. It's the ingredients in the patty itself that distinguishes the Krabby Patty from any other burger from any average restaurant. You know how I know that?
I went to college.
But we still have some recurring characters that haven't been introduced. However, while those characters are still vital, they still don't appear nearly as often as the seven main characters do, but they are still important to the show and deserve focus, but it's obvious which character the creator, Steven Hillenburg, prioritizes in the series. Bottom line, this episode works great as the introduction to the main antagonist to the series, and now that all seven main characters have made their introduction, it feels even more like a focused series, but this is just the beginning and the characters will get better. Mostly.
Plankton was a great episode and introduced the main antagonist in everything he was meant to be, which is important because every series needs a main antagonist. While this is great, this is episode 7, and it introduced main character 7. Illuminati confirmed, everybody! Oh wait. That's a Triforce.